One thing to be aware of though on the MRT is that they do have priority seats, which are these darker blue ones.
举起手机，用英语介绍台湾的大众交通工具，在台北捷运熟门熟路穿梭。他是来自美国加州的柯颖安。
So this story, remember? So we'll read this.
移居台湾五年的他，平常是一位英文老师。当年大学毕业后，曾经迷惘一阵子，后来听了曾到过台湾的朋友分享，决定跨海来台湾尝试新生活。他在台湾遇见来自世界各地的外国朋友，拓展了全球人脉，而台湾朋友总会在生活上帮他一把。在他眼中，台湾人真的很温暖，很热心。
Not even just like getting around, but for opening a bank account, for figuring out visa work, coming with me to the immigration office, going to the doctor, there were so many different things that I didn't realize that would be difficult.
2020年，柯颖安开始拍摄短影音分享旅游资讯，目前拥有数十万粉丝。虽然这些生活资讯影片流量很高，但他最喜欢的却是介绍台湾自然景色的影片。
Originally, I wanted to be like a travel nature type of blogger. And so that's just always been something that I really loved to do.
采访这天，柯颖安带着我们爬台北市的象山。过去曾经在教会实习的他，常常带外国朋友到这里小旅行，已经来过数十次。
Yay! We made it!
因为喜爱登山健行，柯颖安在步道上健步如飞。他分享台湾最让他流连忘返的是阿里山的云雾缭绕与日出，高大的神木总让他想起加州的红木。神木让柯颖安想起家乡，但他不后悔离开舒适圈的决定，因为旅行经验总能让人找到更多启发。
To come to Taiwan? Also to challenge them as well, to get out of their comfort zone, especially in the States, it's very easy to stay in your hometown as well and never really leave.
热爱台湾，一不小心待了五年，柯颖安想把台湾介绍给更多外国朋友，也鼓励年轻人走读世界，遇见更多精彩。